parasitic adaptations. See, generally the parasite shows different types of adaptations. The host environment is not suitable for the parasite. So then the parasite shows some adaptations or developments to tide over the conditions in the host. So in order to face, in order to bear the host environment, the parasite shows adaptations. The parasite shows adaptations. Let's see one by one. The parasites have some special structures which helps in the holding of different types of parts of the host. For example, some of the parasites develops hooks, suckers, rostellum. So some of the parasites develops, these are all hold fast organs. These are used for the holding of host's body parts. So here hooks, suckers, rostellum, these are all used for the anchoring. These are used for the anchoring. So there are development of certain organs or body parts for the purpose of anchoring. Anchoring is nothing but holding of host tissues. So hooks developed, suckers developed, rostellum also developed for the purpose of anchoring. Okay, next thing. So some of the individual's body is covered by protective cuticle. Protective cuticle. So here some of the parasite's body is covered by protective cuticle. Means by that protective cuticle, they can escape from the effect of host enzymes. So when it is living in the host body will produce enzymes on the parasite. So in order to escape from the host enzymes effect, the parasite will develop a protective cuticle which covers its body. Example, if you take Ascaris. So Ascaris body is covered by protective cuticle. Sir, some of the parasites are producing anti-enzymes. Some of the parasites are producing what? Anti-enzymes. Okay. So example, if you take, sir, hooks and suckers example is nothing but Tinea solium. So Tinea solium has anchoring structures like hooks, suckers, rostellum. Protective cuticle is seen in the Ascaris. Next, anti-enzymes are produced by the Tinea solium. Means, in order to face the conditions of the host, the parasites develop, produce some anti-enzymes. So, the anti-enzymes are produced by the Tinea solium. Okay, now, next. See, some of the parasites are obligatory anaerobes. Some of the parasites are obligatory anaerobes. Sir, we have to see what is obligatory anaerobes. So the parasites only which can, the parasite only which can perform anaerobic respiration, which cannot perform aerobic respiration, are called as obligatory anaerobes. Obligatory anaerobes means they 100% perform anaerobic respiration. So the parasites which perform anaerobic respiration in the absence of oxygen is called as obligatory anaerobes. Means they only perform anaerobic respiration. Right? So example, if you see Entamoeba histolytica, you can call it as Tinea solium also. Tinea solium. Okay, so obligatory anaerobes means they perform only anaerobic respiration. Okay, they cannot perform aerobic respiration. Next, some are facultative anaerobes. Sir, what is facultative anaerobes? The parasites which can perform anaerobic respiration in the absence of oxygen. And if oxygen is available, they can perform aerobic respiration. So based on the conditions, the parasite will perform, will perform both the type of respirations. If oxygen is available, it will perform aerobic respiration. If oxygen is not available, it will perform anaerobic respiration. So hence they are called as facultative anaerobes. Example, Ascaris lumbricoides. Ascaris lumbricoides. It can perform aerobic respiration, also it can perform anaerobic respiration. So here some anatomical adaptations or modifications, some morphological adaptations, they helps in the sexual development of the individual. They helps in the sexual development of the individuals. So some of the parasites have enormous reproductive ability. Some of the parasites have enormous reproductive ability. In order to improve their population, they have reproductive ability. They have reproductive ability means they produce more number of individuals to infect the host and to improve their population. Okay. For example, if you take Ascaris. So Ascaris has a great reproductive ability. So it lays 2 lakh eggs per day. So 2 lakh eggs per day. So this is a reproductive ability, sir. This is a reproductive ability of Ascaris. Okay, now. Next, if you take Tinea solium. Sir, Tinea solium body is made up of 700 to 900 proglottids. 700 to 900 proglottids, sir. So, Tinea solium has 700 to 900 proglottids. Each proglottid is a reproductive unit. Each proglottid is a reproductive unit. Means, it can perform reproduction itself. A single segment can perform reproduction. So, it produces 35,000 eggs. So, each proglottid will produce 35,000 eggs. Okay. So, that is the ability of the Tinea solium proglottid. Means, this is the enormous reproductive ability of the parasite to cause the disease to the individual, to infect the individuals. So they have high reproductive ability, they improve their population.